Okey, assalamualaikum. Selamat pagi. Hari pagi tadi hujan, trek basah-basah lagi sikit. Tapi kita hari ni dekat Sepang untuk yes, pandu uji Proton X50. Untuk aktiviti pertama kita kumpulan ni kita akan buat slalom dulu. Okey, ada 2 biji kereta kat sini. Okey, kita akan slalom ke sana. U-turn dan juga lane change tukar lorong. Sempit juga. Tengok macam mana.
Okay, seat belt is on. So guys, say hi to Amirul.
Okay,
we're not going to do any talking because he's going to do talking. But anyway, this is your chance to listen to the engine.
Okay, saya bersama dengan YS. Tapi mungkin korang tak nampak YS Kong yang famous tu, yang Myvi genting tu. Alright. So, aktiviti pertama kita, slalom. Okay, kelajuan dia 50 km/jam. Kita akan maintain 50 ke sana. Dan on the way balik, kita try laju sikit lah. So, kita rasa dia punya body roll dan juga steering feel. Alright.
Main dah maintain constant speed of 50 dalam dalam.
Alright, that was Amirul. Well done, Amirul.
Thank you, thank you.
And so that was the 3-cylinder 1.5 turbo direct injection sound.
Quite smooth, huh?
Yeah, it didn't sound so bad, right?
Yeah.
That's because they have balancer shafts and all that stuff in the engine.
So itu dia, mudah nak kawal. Body roll dia ada sebab ialah SUV kan, nak macam mana. Tapi mudah nak kawal, engine bunyi memang smooth. Yang power dengan gear change DCT ni kita akan rasa pada apa nama ni, drag race nanti. Alright, dalam HRV 1.8 CVT naturally aspirated. So, secara teori HRV akan pergi dulu sebab dia CVT.
Okay, dia kalau dah ready bagi tahu
dekat power bank.
Okay, shift one ready.
S. Oh, terus kasih S. S mode. Okay, okay, shall we team ready?
Honda ready.
On my mark. 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, kita ke depan. Kita dia S50 dah potong. S1 pun dah potong.
Okay, let's go.
Secara teorinya kita akan menang lah untuk ni, untuk round ni.
Honda ready.
Okay, Proton 1 minit. Yep. Okay, Proton ready.
Okay, on my mark. 3, 2, 1, go. Weh, derek kah, jaga.
Okay, 100.
Break. Bagi BMW dulu. BMW go first.
Okay, tadi kita terus floor throttle. Awal-awal dia delay sikit. Tapi lepas 3000 RPM macam tu, terus rasa macam power semua terus masuk. DCT dia saya rasa macam taklah secepat DCT yang saya biasa experience. Dia smooth lah. Smooth, dia tetap cepat, smooth. Cuma dia punya shifting tu dia tak rasa snappy sangat. Mungkin dia tune untuk semua driving conditions dekat awak. Kalau macam VW tu dia tetap lagi snappy. Yang ni kurang sikit, tapi still dia change tu cepat dan paling penting smooth lah. Oh, terus smooth sedap. Macam U-turn. Tekan sikit, responsif. Okay, last round BMW X1. Okay, kat sini mungkin korang boleh tengok S50 tu. Nanti kita tengok macam mana dia pergi.
X1 ready.
Okay, when you guys ready, on my mark. 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, Peratan cakap kenapa dia compare dengan X1 dan juga HR-V. Okay, HR-V dia kata sebab HR-V telah menjadi kereta paling laku keras lah dalam segmen ni, apa nama, crossover ataupun SUV segmen B. Dia market leader. So itulah dia nak compare, nak tengok berapa bagus X50 dengan HR-V. Dan dia letak X1 sebabnya X1 pakai enjin jenis yang sama, 1.5 liter turbo 3 silinder. Gearbox lain lah. X1 kalau tak silap, X1 kampu 8-speed lah, 8-speed ZF,
8-speed, yes, 1.5
engine, 3 cylinder. Okay, cuma X1 tak converter lah. X50 2 clutch, 7-speed. Dan HR-V CVT
also has something called ICC, which is intelligent cruise control. What that does is it combines lane keep assist, or LKA, into the ACC, which basically means that with the camera, it will read the lines on the road and keep you centered in the lane using the steering while adjusting the speed based on the car in front of you. In other words, semi-autonomous driving. If you are weaving a lot, you get a sort of coffee warning, like take a break. Right? Also, if it can sense, it can see quite far with the camera, if it can sense the radius of the corner is relatively sharp, more than 240 degrees, I believe, it will then ask you to make sure you are on the wheel, because you're going to need to turn and assist it. Okay? I pulled away from zero with absolutely no pedals at all, yeah. Okay, so basically no matter what speed I've set my ACC to, it doesn't matter because we only follow what speed he does. So even through a bend, it can still pick up the car. And that's the advantage of having both the camera and the radar. It will pick it up. And it will start to do the steering.
Working, yeah.
All right, so the steering is now being done by the car. There. It's keeping you nice and centered in the lane. All right, you can see the lines being highlighted. It drops off the lines, and at any point I hit the brake, it deactivates the whole flash in the light, as well as the audio.
Okay.
All right, and then when he passes us, which means that it's clear, goes off. And now I can turn out of the way, and now we're clear to go. You see the steering is also being adjusted. Now I take over because of the corner, and he's going to cut in front of us in a rather rude manner. He just cuts in front, picks it up straight away, goes yellow, he goes, oh, that's not safe. So he pulls out a nice safe distance. There's never any panic, any jerky kind of feeling. It's quite a smooth, firm brake.
Yeah, yeah. Very natural.
Yep. It's as if I was driving.
Yeah.
So before I show you, there is one button here yang they've already incorporated. This is your parking button. So if we tekan this button, the 360 camera will come on. And then you can see that you can vertical park, I see you reverse park, you want to side park or exit the parking. You dah tahu you nak cari parking, you dah boleh pre-plan. Okay, I'm going to search for parking. I reselect this while I'm searching. So I'm going to do that for you.
Okay.
Right here. I akan select parallel parking. Sebab this is side parking, right?
Right.
So nampak dia dah lah. Dah start scan for parking.
Yes. Okay. Do you need to signal?
Yes, if you want this one. See, now it scan that parking.
Okay.
So you say you don't want that. You want this one, right?
Alright. Okay, signal here.
So you signal. Dia akan scan balik. Sebab kita dah pass the parking. So once it starts to detect, you the driver will apply the brake.
Okay.
Because
but quite late lah the detection.
I think maybe it was a bit
okay.
Okay. 3 seconds lah. Alright. But let's say if you want it further ahead, you just lepas the brake and you continue to scan lah. So now I want this one. So they here tell you press and hold the brake. Driver will do this and then long press the parking button.
Okay.
So this is the parking button. Press it. It will tell you to release the brakes. So the moment I release the brakes, this is when the car will do
automatically
the parking for you.
Fully.
Drive, reverse, park, steering,
throttle brake,
everything.
Steering, everything, okay.
You just control this button.
Okay. What if we release the button?
Okay, cat passes by, for example. Dia didn't detect. Lepas je.
Lepas the button lah?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, cat, go already.
And it will break.
Yeah. Didn't do anything.
Okay, okay.
Nak continue, just press the button. It will continue to do what it's supposed to do.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, see, it's completed. It says parking is completed. It will automatically go to park for you.
Okay.
You tak payah select.
Let's go.
So it's safe. You tertekan or whatever, it's not going to move anywhere. So now we have parked. Complete.
Okay.
Just more maneuvers lah. If it's tighter.
Yeah.
Until the car has sensed that okay, it's clear. Then it'll ask the driver to take control. So once it's done, you just go to drive. You just look left and right. You ready? You just move up.
Yeah.
Radar picks up the car and the audio warning coming in. Okay. Right, you can see the press brake pedal followed by the toot 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 and the slight triggering of the ABS. Okay, that's the level 3 warning. Yeah, it's not me pressing hard on the brakes. Alright, that's the level 3 warning that jerks the brake. Okay, so this system, it works up to 150 kilometers per hour. Anything. So it picks up the car and it applies the brake for you. Okay, without my foot doing anything on the brake pedal. Okay, so this is really a very last minute thing. Okay, this system will work up to 80 kilometers per hour. Aiming for the apex, very neutral handling. Yeah.
Jadi baru saja lepas taxi ride sepang South Circuit, 2 laps. Jadi dengan taxi ride itu bermakna berakhirlah kita punya hari ini media test drive untuk BMW lah, untuk Proton X50. Tapi yelah, masa taxi ride itu media-media kita semua tak boleh bawa pun, cuma ada instructor yang bawakan kita. Apa yang saya boleh katakan, kalau nak cerita pasal bug sporty handling ataupun dia punya driving dynamics dia, dari segi macam suspension dan juga body control tu sangat baik. Saya tengok ni bukan saya rasa lah, tapi saya tengok saja nampak macam dia punya handling tu agak neutral, tak ada understeer ke apa. Mungkin driver pun sangat berhati-hati dengan kereta, dan driver pun berpengalaman, so dia tak lebih limit kereta, tapi nampak agak neutral. Dari segi pecutan dan juga transmission pula, ni menarik saya nak cerita. Dia punya transmission gearbox 2 clutch DCT ni, 7 speed ni, dia tidaklah macam snappy yang saya sangkakan sangat. Dia tak adalah macam DSG ya. Saya boleh katakan dia lebih mirip ataupun lebih rapat kalau nak bandingkan dengan gearbox automatic biasa. Macam gearbox Volvo atau gearbox BMW punya ZF torque converter biasa. Dia punya sifat ataupun rasa dia lagi rapat dengan torque converter kalau nak bandingkan dengan apa nama ni, dua kelas biasa. Tapi pertukaran gear dia masih lagi sangat cepat. Tapi dia punya kelancaran tu sama sikit sifat macam torque converter. Saya rasa untuk dia nak melindungi gearbox, dan nanti kalau dia buat gearbox apa nama, agresif sangat ataupun terlalu sporty, mungkin maintenance dia lebih tinggi, lebih mahal, nanti korang banyak komplain pula. Jadi yang ni harga dia pun nanti mungkin harga menarik, 80 ke 100 ribu, tak tahu lagi. Saya rasa harga macam tu. Jadi untuk harga macam tu, gearbox macam tu dia buat untuk jaga sikit. Gearbox tu ada sifat dua clutch yang lebih kepada torque converter tu, bagi saya bagus lah, kira okey lah. Lagipun lebih sesuai untuk macam-macam driver, sebab kita pun tak tahu apa Proton X50 ni nanti akan dibeli oleh pelbagai jenis orang. Macam saya pun, kawan-kawan saya yang perempuan pun tanya, yang biasa-biasa yang apa nama, bukan driver-driver yang purist ataupun driver-driver tegar pun tanya berminat dengan kereta ni. Jadi memang boleh dikatakan satu package yang sesuai untuk rakyat Malaysia, sesuai untuk macam-macam jenis driver, tapi tetap ada sikit elemen-elemen sporty kat situ. Jadi sekian saja untuk video kali ini, pandu uji di Litar Sepang Proton X50. Jadi sehingga video akan datang, mungkin kalau kita dapat unit pandu uji ataupun ada sesi media drive lain pula nanti. Jadi terima kasih menonton. Assalamualaikum.